Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to day three of virtual VBS. I sure hope you've been having fun learning about the love of Jesus and the building of our foundation for Him. As we do every day, we're going to go ahead and start with our pledges. So I need you guys all to stand up. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, now we're going to do the Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one brotherhood, united all Christians in service and love. Now the Bible. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word, and will make it a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path, and hide its words in my heart, that I may not sin against God.
This is the song, Remain in My Love. Now you're going to start off with a walk. So you're going to step, step, push down to your knees. One, two, step, step, push down. Two more times, step, step, push down. Last time, step, step, push down. Now the song starts with, as the Father has loved me. So as the Father has loved me, I will also love you. Big circle, also love you. And then you're going to take it from your mouth. These are words from Jesus. These are words full of truth. Bring your hands down like you're praying. Then you're going to go into the chorus. So it says, He says, push out, remain in my love. Do it again. Remain in my love. He says, remain in my love. Then you're going to do a big circle with your arms. Remain in my love. Now we're going to go into the second verse. So as the Father has loved me, I have also loved you. Now back to your mouth again. These are words from our Savior, what He wants us to do. He says, now we're going to go into the chorus again. Remain in my love. Remain in my love. He says, remain in my love. Remain in my love. Now into the bridge. You're going to start with, no better life than this, knowing who Jesus is. No better life than this, living in the love that He gives. So for that, you're going to step out and you're going to do your hands in a circle. So living in the love that He gives. Now you're going to do it again. No better life than this, knowing who Jesus is. No better life than this, living in the love that He gives. And then you're going to do a little jump and then starting to remain in my love. Remain in my love. Remain in my love. He says, remain in my love. Remain in my love. You're going to do it one more time. And then at the end, when you go into your circle, remain in my love. And you're going to end with your feet apart, looking up. And that's the song, Remain in My Love.
Remain in my love.
All right, everybody, y'all come on back. That was some good singing. I don't know about you, but I'm a little exhausted. But I need you to stay standing, and we're going to go ahead and do our VBS motto. All right, ready? Jesus, our strong foundation. All right, that was good, but I need you to do it really loud. Ready? Jesus, our strong foundation. All right, that was great.
This is the song Blueprint. Now you're going to start the song off by kicking your heel two times. So one, two, three, four. Do it again. One, two, three, four. One more time. One, two, three, four. And then you're gonna bring your hands to your knees and you're gonna count here for a four count. Now you're gonna start off with God made a way. So you're gonna bring your hands to your shoulders and lean back. God made a way. And then push up with your hands together. And then you're gonna bring your hand around for you to know him. Bring your hand back around. He came to save you. And with your hands together, you're gonna push down from your sin. What you need to know is. Now we're gonna jump into the ABCs. So A, admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. B, believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And then with your hands together, C, confess your faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Big windmill. Now you're gonna start into the chorus. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build, hammer both your fists down, build your life on the great I am. Then both hands down together. Jesus is everything we need. Now you're gonna do the blueprint one more time. Here is the blueprint. You'll find you are part of a grand design. Then bring your hands down again. Jesus is everything you need. Now you're gonna start into the second verse. God made a way, just like the first verse, for you to know him. He came to save you from your sins. What you need to know is. Then you're gonna go back into the ABCs. Let's do it again. A, admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. B, believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and then C, confess your faith in Jesus as Savior and Lord. So now you're going to jump back into the chorus. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build your life on the great I am. Jesus is everything you need. Do the blueprint again. Here is the blueprint. You'll find you are part of a grand design. Jesus is everything you need. Now you're gonna go right into the bridge. No one has greater love than this to lay down his life for a friend. No one has greater love than this. And you're gonna bring your hands into a circle. Whoa-oh. Do it again. No one has greater love than this to lay down a life for his friend. No one has greater love than this. Oh, whoa-oh. Now you're gonna do the blueprint chorus one more time. Here is the blueprint, God's plan. Build your life on the great I am. Jesus is everything you need. Blueprint one more time. Here is the blueprint. You'll find you are part of a grand design. Jesus is everything you need. Then do Jesus is everything you need. One more time. Jesus is everything you need. Now from here, you're gonna go to your shoulder and then end with your arms up. And now you know the song, Blueprint.
job, guys. I really liked hearing your voices. All right, right now, we're going to go ahead and do our VBS scripture. Now, the words are going to be on your screen. As I read it from the Bible, I want you guys to read it with me. But remember, when we do this, if you got a brother, your sister, your siblings together with you, let's try to say it together, all right? I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6.
And here's the song, Forgiveness. Now you're going to start off by pulling your hand in front of your face and going in a circle, and then do the same thing on the other side. Now verse 1 starts with, there's no way that we can earn it. Bring it in with a fist. There's no way that we deserve it. Another fist right here. Bring your hands down. His love, and then push your arms out to the side, is free, so free. How can it be? And then bring your hands together. How can it be? Now here we're going to go, even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Let's do that again a little bit faster. Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Very nice. And now we're going to jump into the chorus. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. Bring your arm across. While we were yet sinners, Christ died. Bring your wrists together upon the cross. Then scoop up to bring us, with your hands facing you, forgiveness. Do it again. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. We were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. And now for verse 2. There's no way we can attain it. No other way we can explain it. His love, push out again, is free, so free. How can it be? How can it be? Here we go. We're going to do this part again. Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Then we're going to go back into the chorus. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. We were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. Do it again. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. We were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. Now here's the ending part. You're gonna go forgiveness and bring it down. Then the opposite side, forgiveness, bring it down. Then with both hands, forgiveness, bring them down. And then one more time, you're going to scoop up, and it's going to say to bring us forgiveness. You're going to jump into this pose. So it's going to say to bring us forgiveness. And now you know the whole song.
That we can earn it. There's no way that we deserve it. His love is free, so free. How can it be? How can it be? Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us.
It was not such a good start for the young builder. Renzo had smarts, but that's not the same as having wisdom. He had a lot to discover about building things.
Renzo, a competition is doing it faster. Cobra Comb Construction has finished the foundation.
What? How is that possible? We started at the same time.
I didn't know cobras use combs.
I think it's metaphoric.
He's how they're beating us.
Yeehaw! In the dust, Renzo, right?
That's Foreman Niemeyer, the most ruthless and underhanded contractor in the business. If he's involved, we better watch our back.
Hey, Renzo! See this load of girders? That means tomorrow we start building up to the sky. What do you have? Oh, you got a hole in the ground. Tough luck, Renzo. A hole in the ground.
Holes are just upside down mountains.
Hey, guess what? It's quitting time, boys.
Come on, Lloyd.
Ooh, what are we doing?
Getting to the truth. Lloyd, don't make a sound. Starting now.
Oh, I shall call him Growly.
Lloyd!
Growly, why? Take that! Oh, should I give him a turnip bone?
Lloyd, what are you doing?
Oh, I think I'm moving it with my mind.
Lloyd, it's Foreman Niemeyer!
I hope you're not afraid of heights, Renzo. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. Renzo's got a hole in the ground. And now he's up a tree.
Wee!
Lloyd, I've never been this high up. I'm scared.
Don't worry, Renzo. I'll save us. Hi, Renzo.
I'm not feeling safe, Lloyd.
He'll call you Growly Jr.
That's the last straw, kid.
Before you yell, more, let me just say I know how Foreman Niemeyer is beating us.
Go on.
It's easy to build fast when you skip the most important part. Most houses we live in are built on the ground. Pour a little concrete, let it settle a while, and that's okay for a house. But this is a skyscraper. They skipped building a strong foundation.
The higher you build a skyscraper, the stronger the foundation must be. Workers must blast into the solid rock found deep beneath the soil. This supports the entire building and keeps it standing, whatever storm may come.
Mr. Santiago, I'm sorry for being such a goofus.
You're forgiven, kid. So, we're gonna build a strong foundation, or what?
You bet!
Just like a skyscraper's foundation is essential, so are the foundations you are building in your life. Foundations of love and family, and the most important, the foundation in our Heavenly Father. When we follow Jesus, we are digging a deep foundation to prepare us for the good days and the hard ones.
Okay, we have a solid foundation. Now, we head for the clouds.
Good morning, VBSers, and welcome to day 3 of Virtual VBS. Woo, we're halfway there, and I know it's been a great time for you. Man, I sure miss seeing all of your faces and hearing you sing, but I hope you're singing loud at home and you're doing all the moves and you're having a great time. And I also hope that you're listening to the Bible stories as your teachers have been teaching you. Today, you're going to learn more about Jesus and how he loves you and he's pursuing you and he wants a relationship with you. And you know what? That's true all over the world. Jesus wants people to worship him from every tribe and tongue and nation. He wants people from every island to know how great he is. And we've been learning about Puerto Rico and Camarillo. Right there in the middle of Puerto Rico is this city called Camarillo up in the mountains. And it's so beautiful, but sometimes it's kind of hard to get up there. You got to drive up the windy roads. And one time I was driving a big van up there, and man, it's not easy. But here's the cool thing. Through people like you giving, Pastor Jorge has a van that now he's able to go and serve the people in Camarillo. I got a chance to see the van and even ride in the van while I was there with my friend, and I can't wait till you get to meet him on a Zoom call that I'm going to have with him at the end of the week. So we want you to hear part three of Pastor Jorge's story, and then we're going to come back and pray together that the gospel would continue to spread. We hope you're having a great time at Virtual VBS. Watch part three of the story.
Jorge Santiago was born in Camarillo, Puerto Rico. He moved back here just a few months before Hurricane Maria struck his island and left many people without power, food, and even a safe place to live.
We saw the destruction and we saw the needs in our community and our people, and we said we have to do something. We cannot just sit here and wait for other people to come and do something for them. We have to take ownership and we have to do something for our people.
So Jorge began to work with Send Relief, a group of mission teams that came to repair homes and tell people about Jesus. When the mayor of Camarillo saw what they were doing, he gave the teams one of the city carpenters to work with.
I have not worked with volunteers. It was my first time. It was not difficult. I enjoyed their company, their enthusiasm, and their desire to help other people who have lost everything.
As Carlos worked with the teams, they began to share with him, and one volunteer told him how to meet Jesus.
I asked one of the volunteers, "How do you come to know the Lord? How do you come to know Jesus?" We started to talk about his story and my story, and we connected right there.
Carlos decided to follow Jesus, and he was not the only one. Many people came to know Jesus as the volunteers met their needs.
God is doing something very special in Puerto Rico. He's laid the island open for the church to grow, and it's up to us, what are we going to do with it? That's why we need to be here.
Let's pray together. Father, thank you for Pastor Jorge and how faithful he is. Thank you for his energy. And I know it's been hard for so long to work so hard for the gospel to be spread in Camarillo, but we thank you that people are coming to the church and they're hearing about Christ. Thank you that people are getting saved. And Lord, we pray for each child here today, that as they hear the Bible story today, that you would work in their hearts, that they would see how great Jesus is. They would believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and they would come to trust him as their Savior. And we pray the same thing for all the people in Puerto Rico, all the people in Camarillo, and we pray that One Church Camarillo will have a great, great witness and ministry in their city. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great rest of the day.
This is the song, The Rest of My Life. Now you're going to start off to the side, and you're going to scoop in, bring it in, and push out, and then go in a circle. Then do it again, scoop, bring it in, and rotate around. Now for the first verse, you're going to start with your hands down. So nothing's going to hold me. Now step back and push out. Back. Nothing's going to keep me down. Nothing's going to stand in the way of your love scoop in that I have found. Bring it down to your chest. Now you're gonna start with Jesus. So Jesus, I am living in your grace, and on freedom, you're gonna bend down. Freedom, you're all with your hands together. I need. You have given. You're gonna bring your hands apart. Me a future to believe in, and I believe. Now for the chorus, you're gonna start with your palm up. The rest of my life is yours. The rest of my life is for. Now you're gonna go to your side, praising you and loving you, then both arms up and living in your truth. Then both hands up, the rest of my life is yours. And then on Lord, you're gonna turn. So it's gonna go, the rest of my life is yours, Lord. And then go back to the beginning. So you're gonna scoop, bring it in, around, scoop, bring it in, around. Now for verse 2. So these, you're gonna have your hands up. So I will place my hope in, step back, you, in everything I say and do. I will walk with you every day, no matter, hands back up, what I'm going through, back down to your chest. Now we're gonna go back into the chorus. Jesus, I am living in your grace and freedom. You're all I need, hands down. You have given me a future to believe in, and I believe. And the rest of my life. The rest of my life is yours. The rest of my life is for praising you and loving you and living in your truth. The rest of my life is yours. And then on Lord, you're gonna turn around in one big circle, keeping your hands up. And then at the end, you're gonna bring them down. So now we're gonna go back into Jesus, I am living in your grace. So Jesus, I am living in your grace and freedom. You're all I need. You have given me a future to believe in. Now I believe. Now we're gonna do the rest of my life one more time. The rest of my life is yours. The rest of my life is for praising you and loving you and living in your truth. The rest of my life is yours. And then on Lord, turn back. Lord, scoop, bring it in, turn around, scoop, bring it in, turn around. And then from here, you're gonna bring your hands apart and freeze. And that's the song, The Rest of My Life.
Jesus.
Good morning and welcome to day 3 of virtual VBS here at Old Palatine. We are so glad that you are with us again today, and this week I know you have already been learning about how much Jesus loves you. Our story today comes from Matthew 26, verses 36 to 46. The point of our story today is that Jesus chose to die for me. Jesus knew he had come to earth to be the Savior of the world. He knew that meant he would have to die. On the last night Jesus spent with his disciples, he took them to a place called Gethsemane. Jesus said to the men, "Sit here while I go pray." Then Jesus asked Peter and two other disciples, James and John, to go a little farther with him. Jesus was very sad and troubled because he knew he was going to die on the cross to save people, to save us, from their sins. Jesus asked Peter, James, and John to stay awake with him because he was so distressed. When Jesus had gone a little farther into the garden alone, he fell to his knees and began to pray. He asked God if there was any other way to provide forgiveness other than by dying. Jesus did not want to disobey his Father, but he also knew all things are possible for God. Jesus told God that he would do whatever God wanted him to do. Jesus returned to Peter, James, and John, but found them sleeping. He said to Peter, "Couldn't you stay awake with me for just an hour? Stay awake and pray." Jesus went alone a second time to pray. When he came back, the three were asleep again because they could not keep their eyes open. Finally, Jesus went alone a third time to pray. When he returned and found the three men sleeping, he told them to get up and go with him. Jesus knew it was time to go with the soldiers and follow through with God's plan. He was willing to suffer and die on the cross to save us from our sins. In our story, Jesus was very disappointed in the actions of the disciples because they slept even though he asked them to pray. But even though he may have been disappointed, and even though he may be disappointed in our actions, he still chose to die on the cross for you and for me because he loves us. Jesus, thank you for loving us. Thank you for dying on the cross. Thank you for following God's plan. So the point of our story today was that Jesus chose to die for me and for you. Can't wait to see you tomorrow for day 4.
Can be my shield. he showed me on that cross, he will come to me. For the Lord is good and faithful, he will keep us day.
This is the song Concrete and Cranes. Now to start off with, you're gonna take your jackhammer and you're gonna push down twice. Then you're gonna take your saw and pull that twice. Jackhammer two more times, one, two, and then one more saw, and then you're gonna go around in a circle. Now we're gonna start verse one. Now it starts with hard hats and hammers, levels and ladders. Construction has begun, do two digs right here. Now rivets and ratchets, you're gonna pull your hand three times, rivets and ratchets, gauges and gadgets. That's how we get it done. And now for the chorus. You're gonna start with concrete and crane. Hold your hand right here like you're holding a microphone. We're building our faith, two hammers, on Christ, the cornerstone. The foundation's laid. The foundation's laid, the cross beams are raised, our strength is God alone, concrete and cranes. So after the first chorus, you're going to take your jackhammer and you're gonna go one, then you're gonna do the saw one more time, and then you're gonna go around in a circle. Now we're gonna start verse two. So it's love and forgiveness. That's what he gives us to build our lives upon. You're gonna do scoop twice. Now, we won't be shaken from this foundation. Our God will make us strong. Two muscles right there. Then you get to go back into the chorus. So we're gonna do that one more time. Concrete and cranes, we're building our faith on Christ, the cornerstone. The foundation's laid, the cross beams are raised, our strength is God alone, concrete and cranes. Now, after that chorus, you're gonna go into the bridge. So from here, you're gonna do a swipe here, and then you're going to lean this way, and then you're gonna start by pulling your hands to your chest. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you, now you're gonna put your hands right in front of you, will carry it on to completion. And on completion, you're gonna make a big circle. Let's try that one more time. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion. Now we're gonna say until the day of Christ. So you're gonna make a big circle until the day of Christ. Now step back and do a big windmill, Jesus. And then you get to go back into the chorus. Now after the bridge, you're going to do the chorus two more times. And you're gonna end with concrete and cranes. And you're gonna hold this for your ending pose. And that's the theme song for Concrete and Cranes.
that's it for day 3. We hope you have a good afternoon. Invite a friend, and we'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.